Hi guys, welcome back. Apologies for the amount of videos for these ones. One reason it's come out in like two or three portions. I'm a bit of a technophobe. I don't really know how to link the videos together. So apologies. Right, so it's been about an hour since I dropped the inks. And the sinkers as well. And if we just go to this one over here, see it's quite stringy. Alright, we'll do these ones to start off with. So for this one we did like a yellow and an orange. Say really stringy. Now we'll do the red one. Well, I'm just going to pull right into the middle itself. Purple one. Purple one as well. See, the effects really are just random. Right, it's this black and white one. So, shall I pull the black into the white or white into the black? this was a little messy on this one. That is really random on that one. We need to get better equipment, but well, go back down. Right, so we'll do these ones. I don't know what's going to come out of this one because I'm going to say it's so. Bit of a mismatch on top. Be okay then. I don't know. But we shall see. Still a little bit of negative space there. Right. So I'm just going to bring the purple into the orange. Drag the orange into the purple. And just leave it there. Big one. Right, this one. I'm just going to start on the outside. When you're doing your patterns with your whatever you're using, whether it be a thin needle like this, where you can actually use a really thin drill if you've got drill bits. Safety pin. Well, I think the safety pins are too thick, really, to be honest. Personally, you can use a needle. People should have plenty of needles knocking about around the place. Right, let me just. Up a little bit. Mm-hmm. So, right. Let's move up. Sorry guys, my camera work is shocking. Right, so we went around that way with that one. So what we're gonna do with this one? Yeah, when you're using your needle, whatever you're using, don't go too deep, because if you do, you're going to scratch your mold, and once you scratch your mold, that's that scratch is going to be left on your future molds. So really, it's not really worth it, to be honest. In there. I'm not sinking back in. So, got this green one. Don't know what to do with this one. I've still got a little bit of a negative space there, a little bit there. Will be a little bit of space at the top, because as I say, when the inks are put in, you lose that little bit of that space, because the resin concaves back into the mold. So at these edges you'll have like a lip where it goes in a little bit. You can leave it like that, or wait a couple of hours just to top up with a little bit of resin. You don't need a lot at the top, just gives it that that flat surface, or if you want a bit of a, you know, concave one, just overfill it a little bit. But that's what I tend to do anyway. If I find I've got a bit of a lip there, I'll just make up a little bit of resin, just wait until, you know, it's tacky on the top. I don't want to be putting resin in and then messing up the designs as well, because if I put resin in now, basically it's going to put like a clear spot wherever I put the resin. So if you wait two or three hours, or even, you know, 24 hours, put resin on top, it'll still be fine. But I tend to wait, you know, 2, 3, 4 hours after I've done the pouring, my inks, swirling, you know, 3 or 4 hours, I put a little bit of extra resin on top just to make it level as well. So that's me. As I say, everybody is different. It's what you find is best for you, what you're comfortable with doing. But that's how I do it. So as I say, everybody is different. So I'm just onto these four, and then we've just got four left to do. So, well, yeah, so I'm dropping dropped a load of resin down here soon, but that's fine. Still got a little bit of a native space there as well. Just thought of something to try. It might go really, really wrong, or it might come out looking really, really good. If you guys want to try it, that's fine. So what I was thinking of, obviously you put your resin in the cups. Yeah. So I'm just thinking, leave the resin in the cups, do exactly what you do in the molds in the cups, but at this point, instead of swirling, obviously put your resin in, your inks, your sinker, and then pour it into your mold. As I say, it may come out looking really, really good, it may come out looking really, really bad. Think about, I suppose. Right, so let's carry on doing this one. Right, I'm just going to bring the purple. Down into the orange. And then I'm going to bring the orange. These two colours, I kind of forgot what these were. Don't know if these were orange and black. Don't know. So let's move you along. So, these were purple and orange. Thank you. that one with the orange. Right, now I'm just going to bring the orange slightly into the purple. Let's roll that a little bit more. Right, so this one. I think this was the yellow and purple. So I'm just going to bring the purple into the yellow or orange and bring the yellow back into the purple. Now see, you don't have to leave them for an hour to do the swirls, you can leave them half an hour. But I found anything more than an hour and it just gets too you just can't do the swirls or the designs in it as good. So right, this one. So this one, you can, well, you probably not be able to see it. I have got a little bit of a lip here already going in where it's concaved in a little bit. So that will need topping up after. So I think I did an orange, 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 and black up here. So I'm going to bring the black into the orange. So these last three, so I'm just going to, and the last two. I don't really have, like I say, any preconceived idea of what I'm going to be doing with these patterns. I'm just looking at it and thinking, will it be okay looking like that, half at a time, just do whatever, to be honest. So I'm just going to leave them now. I say, may need to do some top ups. So, but as I say, that one, that's going to need a top up, definitely, because it's got that little bit of a lip on it. So, we'll see what these come out with. Might be quite good. Remember, not bad. Bit of a negative space on that one, but we'll still see. A few bits of negative space on there. Let's say that one. I don't think that's going to be turned into much, to be honest. I've got these ones as well. That one might come out okay. Just have to wait and see what kind of designs we've got with these guys. I say what design you can see on the top doesn't always resemble what comes out underneath, to be honest. Yeah, we've got crosses as well. That might come out okay. Don't know. Just have to wait and see. Probably at the white bit, probably have a bit of translucent. Probably might be a bit see through that, but might be okay. But we shall see. Okay, guys, thank you for checking in with me again. And we shall see you tomorrow for the demolding. Okay, guys, thanks so much. And if you can, do us a share, do us a like, much appreciated. I'd say thank you for the subscribers as well. 13 subscribers. So, I'll say like a few more. But if not, it is what it is. Okay, guys, thanks. Bye.